We're here at WorldCon 74 and Mid-America Con 2, and this is the last final day. You still have some items available. Explain to me how this is set up between WorldCon and how this works.
Well, I'm Barb with Off World Designs, and we have the license to do the souvenirs for the WorldCon. You can get anything we have left over after today on our website, offworlddesigns.com. We still have quite a few things. It's been good.
And you said that, so WorldCon gets a commission off of everything that is sold here.
Correct. And the World Science Fiction Convention travels from city to city, so next year it will be a completely different group of fans running the WorldCon in Helsinki.
And I understand you guys got a shout-out by a very famous person.
Yes, we did. George Takei posted one of our t-shirts this week, and we couldn't be more thrilled.
It's kind of nice to get that little nod, isn't it?
It is. We've been doing this a long time, and that's the first time that we've ever had him post one of our pictures, so it's wonderful.
How many of these WorldCons have you been to?
Oh, probably 87 was my first one, so goes back a ways.
Okay, for a moment there, I thought you were going to say you'd been to 87 of them, and I was going to say that's not possible.
No, not quite. Feels like it.
I'm sure, after 5 days at each one, yeah. I'm interested in how this one, how do the different WorldCons vary?
Well, they all have their own flavor, depending on the city, and there are certain things that are consistent. We have a lot of traditions in WorldCon, the Hugos, the masquerade, parties, but each city brings their own flair to it.
Is this a consistent thing as well, having the souvenir shop?
Well, different people have bid on it. We've done it several years. It just depends, but...
So you've traveled from WorldCon to WorldCon?
Oh, yes. We did the souvenirs in London a few years ago. That was very fun.
Were their souvenirs very different?
Well, let's see. We had a dragon with the Union Jack on it, which, of course, Americans loved, and the Irish were not so crazy about.
So those things become more specific to the location and who's going to like it and who doesn't. I hadn't thought about that.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So what has been your best seller of their t-shirts?
Probably the original logo with the, there's four iconic statues on top of this building and they're featured in the logo. So that meant a lot to Kansas Cityans, so that's been number one.
Has that sold well for people who aren't here from Kansas City?
Oh, yes.
Interesting, because I think of them as being very iconic to here, but other people might not appreciate them.
Yeah, I think everybody's behind what the committee wants to do, and that's what they were putting forward. One thing that we have that's really unique is we have a shirt that says Honoring WorldCon, and if I'll just grab one real quick. This one says Honoring Science Fiction Literature Since 1939 on the front, and on the back it has the entire list of WorldCons dating back to the first one and including which years were missed for the World War II. So it's a t-shirt and a reference material.
History, it's wearable history.
That's exactly right.
Oh, I like that one. Thank you so much for your time.